Hi guys, so today we'll be talking about the best accessories for PvP. A lot of people think that fire accessory is the ends all means all for PvP and PvE for DPS, but that is actually false. So if you're a mid to late, I mean mid game player, or even a late game player, but not yet like a peak whale level player, you should not be using fire accessories on PvP specifically. PvE, you'll still be using fire accessories, but you want to build wind accessories on the side. Because wind set is just much better if you aren't like a top tier PvPer. Let's just say like you're not in the top five, that then you shouldn't be. You're not in the top five of the region, then you shouldn't be using fire accessories if you want to play competitively against like the top five squads. The reason being is that you will get one shot if you use fire accessories if you're not within this range, unless you're building like a super tanky build, which most people aren't. Most people are running like some dog water mech pieces not meant for PvP. Like let's see. See, dog water, dog water, dog water. Dog water. If you're not running all the reduction pieces, then you're just gonna get slapped. But if you run wind, you won't need break to kill people. The reason being is that the wind multiplier is really high. Look at my dog water wind set, man. It's so shit, it's level 15. I mean, where's my last one? It's so shit, it's level 18. But look at this wind slicer. It increases damage based on your dodge rate, so you could get like 300% damage within the bubble period, which is enough to kill anyone. And you'll be very tanky and dodgy. Dodge basically negates all damage. You could still get stunned if you dodge, but it's much harder for you to die, and it gives you much more room for error. The main thing about PvP is not one-shotting someone, it's more about the amount of room for error you have, the amount of hits you can take, and how you can improve on that. Because if you're thinking about one-shotting someone, you're never gonna be able to PvP realistically. Only like Giga Whales will be one-shotting people. But anyone can build a tanky build that can maybe resist the Giga Whales, such as having high wind. You could like dodge more hits and stall more time until your bubble comes, and then you might be able to contest them while you have your bubble up. This is also the case because even Mayu Pro can destroy war mounts with wind bubble. And then after they're demounted by Mayu or Natsu by someone else, your wind bubble will just directly kill them. You're gonna ask me why, what I use, I obviously use Fire Set, but I do believe in Wind Set. But that's because I'm really well. And if you're gonna ask about the state of Ice Set, just don't use it. Whether you're Priest, DPS, or whatever the hell you are, it does not matter. Because, well, technically Ice Set is pretty good in PvE for Priest, but that's about it. Because Heavy does work in PvE, despite what other people may claim. What do you want to run with Wind? You want to drop all your crit rate, and you want to have only 100% crit rate and like zero break. Just rock Indom, Tenacity, and that's it. This being the case is because the other, like, break is a dead stat as a wind build, because it literally doesn't, you won't even have enough break to penetrate their tenacity whatsoever. And yeah, this is why I believe wind accessory is the best accessories for DPS and PvP. I hope you guys liked my explanation. Have a nice day. See you guys next time.